Having a multi-purpose living room that includes a playroom and an office space can be very difficult at times. We are super blessed to have this closet. That's kind of an interesting closet. And I recently reorganized it and I thought it'd be fun to show you guys what I did, even though chances are you probably don't have the exact same closet in your office space, but it may give you some ideas of how to organize a small space on a budget. So I went to the Dollar Tree, Target, and then just shopped my home for the most part and got some things that were very inexpensive, got some labels from Amazon, and I completely made over the space. Before, it was just overflowing with stuff. There was just stuff everywhere and I didn't have a good system for it, even though I had tried to organize it with bins in the past. But now, having lived with it for a couple years, I've realized that book bins were a way better solution for this space. It is very, very narrow shelves because our fridge actually sits in most of the closet on the other side. And so we only have like a few inches of shelf depth, but it ended up being perfect for book bins. So I'll show you guys that. And along the top above the fridge is the full width and depth of the closet, so it's a lot bigger area. So I thought that'd be a perfect area for some of the bigger items like my paper cutter and things like that that I don't need to access very often and that take up a lot more room, and I like that they're high up so that my kids can't get into them. So the very first thing I did was just empty everything out. I brought it all into our dining room, onto our dining table, and just was like, how is that much stuff sitting in there? And then I went through and I sorted it. So I sorted it based on things I can recycle, things I want to donate, things I can relocate to another area of the house that would make more sense, like storage for pictures instead of our office closet. Just doesn't make sense to keep pictures and letters and stuff that people wrote us in here, as well as some of my old planners like my Filofax that I still love and may use one day. It just doesn't make sense storing it in here when it makes more sense to store it in our storage room. So I did that, and then I went through and I lined up a bunch of bins and I started putting things into those according to type. And by the end, everything was organized and fit on the shelves really nicely. And then it was just a matter of figuring out what the best place and design layout would be. Now the shelves are already fixed too, so I couldn't just like easily move them around without drilling more holes and things that I didn't want to do. So this project only took about an hour. And then I got some nice labels with a thin chalk marker and then wrote all the labels on there so we can easily put stuff back, especially having more than one person in this house. It's nice to be able to put stuff back nicely. So I'm just gonna take you guys through top to bottom what I'm storing in here and how I am storing it. So on the very top shelf, like I said, I have these book bins. I got these all at the Dollar Tree. So here, I spent $3. This bin I already had was from the Dollar Tree as well. So in here we have our baby books. In here we have file folders, so manila folders, and then the hanging file folders. And then in here I have just regular folders and then like planner and binder dividers, so they all fit in there. I've got my laminating pouches. And then in here I've got our camera and DVD player accessories. So we have like a little portable DVD player, so I keep that in here, as well as some of extra overflow camera accessories. And then up here at the top, I also keep some of the really big envelopes that wouldn't fit anywhere else because they were too tall. So I just tuck them in there. And then like I said, up here is the full depth of the entire closet. So this is a great space for things that I don't access a lot, that I didn't want in storage, but that, you know, are either bigger or just things that I don't need to access all the time. So I have some of my really nice staples binders. I love them. Sometimes I will just want one for something, and so I'm keeping them. I could have donated them, but I didn't want to have to run to the store if I want one because they're really high quality. And then I have my Orla Kylie planning binder kit thing. I don't keep planning stuff anymore in there. I'll show you in a second. It's all right here. But I do really still like that and may use it for something else. And then I have my laminator up here that I access quite frequently, and my two paper cutters because I didn't want them low to the ground and my kids cutting themselves, and the bigger one is really big and so it wouldn't fit on a shelf. So that works perfectly, and it's really easy to just clear stuff out of the way to get to it since I'm not accessing them very often. And I just love how easy it is to get things in and out now, especially from the top, because I do have them all separated into very small categories, and when I need something, it's really easy to find it. Okay, this next shelf is my favorite shelf. It's my stuff I need to access quite frequently. It's at eye level, it's easy to get to, and my kids can't reach it yet, so that's great. So in this first little caddy, I got these blue ones from Target in the school supply section. They have three compartments and they're easy to pull in and out. And I just stuck a label on them so I can separate them by use. So this one is office supplies that I use on a regular basis. So I've got scissors, I've got staplers, and then I've got these little containers. I believe I got at IKEA. They're the spice jars. And I got them quite a few years ago, and I just keep paper clips and little clips and things in those so that I can access them easily, and they fit perfectly in here, three of them on the bigger side. I have this little drawer system here with smaller items. So I've got our post-its in one, sticker tabs in another for planning and things like that when I'm setting up a binder or my planner. Craft supplies, so like a little tube of Mod Podge, a little craft cutter and some Velcro, just things that I use enough that I want them close by. I've got another drawer with some extra scissors, and then office tools, which is just like some random, like a paper hole punch, and then the labels and chalk markers that I use for this project because I really like them and I had a lot of leftovers. Over here in these smaller containers, I got these from the Dollar Tree. These are little Sterilite containers. They're the perfect size for washi tape, so I've got two of those. And over here is my little planner supplies caddy. I love this because I can just easily take it out, bring it to the table, desk, island, wherever I'm doing my planning, and it's got all my stickers, it's got little inspirational quotes, it's got tons of different colored pens, it's got my little stampers that I sometimes use in my planner, and it's just the perfect size. And once again, this is from Target in the school supply section. Moving down a row, I have things that I also use on a very regular basis. This shelf was not very tall, so I couldn't fit some of the extra ones that I put up top, so that's why I just have these here. Plus, it wasn't wide enough for all of my book bins, so this worked out really well. So here I just have regular paper. I just take it right out of the container when I buy paper and I put it in here so I can easily access it. Before, I was trying to like pull it out and it was falling and then they were getting all folded, so now it's very neat and tidy and organized. Here I have specialty paper like photo paper, label paper, and different colored papers. Here I have wallets and checks, so any extra wallets I have that I want to sometimes switch to or use for something, and all of our checks so I know where those are. Here I have mailing supplies, so just standard envelopes and stamps, and our address stamper and things like that are in here. Over here I have notebooks, so whenever we need a notebook we know where they are. And then in the last one I have envelopes. So these are like greeting card size and different size envelopes, as well as the bubble mailers that are smaller and can fit in there. And then over here I have just some sheet protectors as well, since they fit better in a box than being all floppy in the book bin. So that's perfect. And then down here I have these containers. They were five for $5.99 at Target, and I'm using four here. And then I'm also using a pencil case that I believe I got at Target. That's a Sterilite brand. It was probably a dollar or so. I'm not exactly sure, maybe 50 cents. I can't remember. In these, I hold like extra things or bigger things that obviously wouldn't fit in the book bins. So I have our label maker with the cartridges and the battery separate because they always die if they're left in there for whatever reason. I've got our external hard drives and the cords that go along with those. I've got overflow office supplies, so extra staples, tape, push pins since I don't use those very much, and just some other random office supplies that I don't need to use quite often but that I want to have handy in the case that I do need them. And then I also have a bin with notepads and index cards that I will pull out once in a while. And then in this little pencil case, I just have an extra camera and some extra chargers for our cameras. And then down here at the bottom, I have switched all of our DVDs. So a couple years ago, I actually switched to taking all of the DVD cases away. I recycled them and I put all of the DVDs into just little sleeves and kept them in little cases, but I just didn't really like that. I still think it was really hard to find what I was looking for, so I moved it all into one giant CD binder. And so I have all of our seasons of episodes, all of our movies, all of our exercise videos, all of our Christmas movies. Everything is in here with room to spare, and I really like this because when my kids want to watch a movie, They can actually see what's in there and pick and choose, and we can find them really easily because we can see 8 at a time, which is really nice. And I just love this, so I'll link to that below. And then here I have my camera bag that holds our like YouTube and photography camera equipment. But the really awesome part is that we still have all this extra room down here that I plan to put any overflow extra toys or bigger toys for our girls, since this is actually in their like little play area, like a dollhouse or something like that that won't fit in their bins but I don't want sitting out. I am reserving it, that space, for them. So it worked out perfectly. I have just enough extra room and it looks so organized and neat and tidy, and I love it. One area I haven't utilized, but I literally, as I was filming this, was just looking at, is the door. Now, because it's a very narrow closet, I don't know if I'd be able to do this, but I would really love to add a gift wrap station to this closet, because what we have going on right now is just this really clunky zip-up storage that fits under our bed, but stuff's always falling out of it. It's really hard to get to. It's annoying to clean back up. So if we could fit those on the door, I would consider it. I just don't know if we have enough space. But that's another idea if you have a small home or you don't have a lot of storage, is to put your gift wrap and all your wrapping paper and bows and stuff on the back of a door. It is something I might consider in the future. So this is my really organized office closet. I love it. I love that my husband can find stuff when he's looking for it because it's finally labeled. When my kids get older and need to find something, they'll be able to. And it's going to be really easy to adapt over the years. I just love how sleek and organized it is, and I did it all for under $30. I hope you guys enjoyed this video of my organization. I plan to do a lot more micro organizing videos in the future, hopefully one a month if I can stick to it. So make sure you're subscribed so you can stay tuned for that, as well as a lot of other content for working moms, busy moms, and people with big goals who want to go after life. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye guys.